Great comedians and actors have a lot to teach us about being on camera because they approach it from opposite ends of the spectrum. We don't usually think of it this way, but understanding this will free you to be your absolute best self in front of the camera. So put your boots on. We're about to wade into deep waters. I have to tell you a little secret. For several years, I had a fantasy about being a comedian, but I would only do my little act in very controlled environments. That's because I never had any desire to suffer the slings and arrows of being outrageously bad at it. But there's another reason that career path wasn't in the cards for me, and it may change the way you think about being on camera. Comedians spend years honing their sense of timing, their sense of humor, and their sense of themselves. Actors spend years honing their sense of character, energy, and relationship. All of these elements exist on a continuum of identity. On one end, you have no idea who you are or why you're here. On the other end, you have an unshakable faith in everything about who you are. Great comedians are usually at that end of the spectrum. They use who they are as the foundation for their act, their performance. Jerry Seinfeld has said he was not a good actor because he couldn't play any character other than himself. Great actors like Daniel Day-Lewis are often at the opposite end of that spectrum. They like to submerge who they are so they can disappear into the role. So, what's the best approach for you? Before you say, well, oh, being myself, of course, understand that many people don't have a reliable way of knowing who they are because it's hidden in their unconscious. I'm one of them. In human design, where your video DNA comes from, it looks like this. We have all these energy centers scattered throughout ourselves, and one of them is the center of self. If this isn't filled in, you're kind of a blank slate. So you tend to learn about your identity from those around you. Take the best and leave the rest. There's nothing good or bad about it. It's just different. Great actors often do not have this center filled in. This makes it very natural for them to try on different roles without feeling weird. You get a lot of wisdom from stepping into someone else's shoes, gives you empathy. Now, you're probably not on one end of the spectrum, so how do you find your most authentic way of putting yourself on camera? Well, no matter what side of the spectrum you're on, you've always had something in common with someone on the other side. Because every day, both of you play roles in life. Father, mother, husband, wife, friend, boss, employee, and the list goes on and on. These roles are shorthand ways of accessing those parts of yourself that are most appropriate to the situation. Even if you can only be yourself, you wouldn't play husband to an employee who isn't your wife. And someone who doesn't have a defined sense of self can find it easy to be around all different kinds of people. They're natural chameleons. They can make the other guy feel comfortable without losing themselves. So I'm bringing all this up because if you want to really feel right and in your best self on camera, it's good to do it in a way that broadcasts who you really are, even if you don't know exactly who that is, because it comes out in ways that other people can see, even if you can't. In your body graph, you'll find notes of personality, all of which are plain to you, and other notes in your design, which are pretty well hidden from your sight, but astoundingly clear to others. Your responsibility is to allow your full humanity to come out and play. Even the parts most people try to hide, but which their design puts on full display anyway. It's the combination of personality and design that gives you your on-camera power. And not just on camera. It also helps you with your tech, your writing, the kinds of videos you make, your selling. You want to make videos that work. Bring all of you to the table. It's the easiest way to give your videos a boost of authenticity. In these days of artificial voices, AI scripting drivel, and robotic presentations, being who you are in all your inspired silliness or seriousness mysticism or utter rationality, your audience will find you strangely irresistible. And this is kind of the whole point of building your business on the strength of visible authority.